All right.
So I'm Daniel from QSpark. I also work in an NHFT firm with Nimrod, and I specialize in high performance environments where every microsecond counts. And today I want to show you this nice neat data structure called the static flat map. It's a specialization of a map that works in very specific environments, and it's very good for these. So first, let's take a look at why the presentation doesn't work. Never mind. So why is the standard not enough for us? Usually STD map is great, we use it all the time, but sometimes it just doesn't fit our needs. Let's take an example here. We have some multi-threaded map, like some map that everyone edits, and we have a lock that's very expensive that, and we need to lock the map and iterate over it, do some calculations, do some stuff. This is an unacceptable piece of code in our high performance environment because we lock all the threads that are pushing for the map, and we can't work like that. So I thought of a clever solution. You might know it. I have a local copy of the map, then I copy from the big map to the local copy, and then I do the iterations and the calculations on the local copy, assuming that this is faster. Actually, measurements show this is much slower, and further measurements show that most of the time I spend is on actually copying the map. So what's going on here? The STD map for our use is too safe. There are too many edge cases that it takes care of, and we don't need that, and it costs us in runtime. It's too general. It cares mostly about inserts, removes, and lookups. We don't care about inserts and removes. We know the keys in initialization time. And it's too dynamic. The memory is allocated all over the place. And we want it to be sequential, something that's fast to iterate over. Bottom line is the STL solution for an ordered map is just too complicated for us. All we want is this little piece of string, and we get everything. And so the solution is simplicity. I created a map that is nothing but a sorted array that has binary search to find item. That's it. That is the static flat map. It is extremely simple, and it's powerful because of that. These are the measurements for the function that I showed before. The copy and everything for the STD map took around 25 microseconds. The new static flat map, it took less than a single microsecond, which made it from unusable to actually kind of nice. So why is it so fast? So first of all, it's an array. It's sequential. All the data is sequential in memory, which makes iteration fast, which makes copy fast. Also, we use locality. Everything is one bunch, so everything is cached up and warm and ready to use. And it's simple, no edge cases, nothing special, just an array, use binary search, that's all. So when should you use it? Basically, let's look at the pros and cons. We have quick iteration, we have quick copy, we have quick lookup and edit. The binary search is log n, which is the same as the STD map. And it's sequential and it's static, giving us all the performance boost we wanted. The cons, very slow inserts and very slow removes because you need to reorganize the map every time. It's limited in size, you need to know the size in advance because it's static. Not as good for large maps and not as good for large objects. Because again, reordering it will be expensive the larger it is. So in conclusion, the standard STD map is great, but it doesn't always fit our needs, so maybe we need another solution sometimes. Use this thing, you can use it and you should use it with care. Remember that it's good for like if you know the keys in advance, and if it's small, and if you need more copies and iterations than you need the inserts and remove, and always measure. Like you couldn't always go and try to use it thinking it might be faster, but if you don't measure, you don't actually know. So always measure, even if it looks like it should be good. Like my favorite mug says, it doesn't matter how beautiful your theory is or how smart you are if it doesn't agree with experiment. It's wrong. That's it. Thank you all. You can find the map at this GitHub, and you can find me at this now.